Man, I hate determinants. We're gonna curb that discussion for next episode, because in this episode, we are making number go up, part two.
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes.
So, ladies and gentlemen, if you've been following the saga, we are at the point in our tale. We're trying to increase our D cheddar over D time. And, not to reuse an analogy, but we're gonna use the firewood again, because that's what I'm doing and it kind of works. Also, they're kind of wedge-shaped, akin to a wedge of cheddar. Our plan, we're mathematicians, remember, our plan is to increase our stacks, try to take our individual elements of cheddar, and form 5 stacks of cheddar. Now, we have tried a lemonade stand, but that did not work. However, we are bloomers, and we have a bloomer attitude. It is off to the drawing board. The direction is clear. Now all we need to do is scalar multiply. A lot. Come on, cheddar. Get up there. To the lab. I get a little carried away with the intro edits, my bad. Problem is, the actual explanation is like 30 seconds long, so this is gonna be like a small portion of the video, but it's like kind of what it was leading to. I'm still figuring out my style, you understand. I wrote this down to make sure I stay on topic because I will ramble. So the fundamental idea is we need examples to abstract from. We are mathematicians, right? And so how do we make money? We want some sort of mathematical theory, some sort of understanding, some sort of something to understand how to go about doing so. A mental tool, mathematics is a tool to go forth in the world is what we're going for here. So I gotta support myself, nay, thrive, while I do the self-education stuff. And I gotta figure out how to do so. I'm looking at myself, looking inside, saying what skills do I have? I can do math. Can I apply that to making money? Perhaps. It seems like money is a numerical thing. So let's try doing that. I'm gonna try to integrate somehow mathematical money. But first we need examples. That's the problem, is we need examples to abstract from. Yeah, abstractions from nothing is nothing. So you need to have a lot of examples in order to abstract some sort theory. And so that is what we're gonna go do. We're gonna go try different business models, and I'm gonna take you along for the journey. And that's the first step, is get examples. And then we can abstract later. The examples are first. In any mathematical endeavor or any scientific endeavor, we need examples, experiments, whatnot. So we are gonna get examples up the yin yang, hopefully some that work, and then maybe that might actually stop me from getting more examples, because it'll be the one that works, and we'll stick with that. In the meantime, we're gonna get as many examples as we can, see which ones work, which ones don't. Talk of businesses. Examples are the businesses, and then from that we extract how to make money. So we're gonna start businesses, see what works. I've done a couple of these already, so it's not like I'm totally new to the field, but yeah, it should be exciting. In the next episode, because 4 episodes of being up in the air, abstracted, it's like, all right, I'm done with that. We gotta get concrete, get some examples down. The next episode of this, we will make at least $1 on camera, somehow. No idea how yet, and it can't be like from a job or something. So $1 will be made on camera. That's the challenge. And that's pretty much it. So this has been the lab segment. Thank you very much for sticking around. Without further ado, take it easy. I love you. Godspeed, and I will see you in the next one, which is going to be tomorrow. And I know it's gonna be